In the final San Diego State home game of the season, Jamal Franklin saved his best for last, scoring 31 points and pulling down 16 rebounds as San Diego State scored a 74-66 victory over Colorado State to force a three-way tie for first above the Mountain West Conference with New Mexico and UNLV. And Edward, we were kind of joking around after the game that the sophomore Franklin didn't get the memo that it was senior night.
Yeah, no, I mean, he didn't. I mean, he took over the show. I tweeted this, and I think people kind of – it was eye-opening tweet. You know, he looks like Kawhi Leonard. We were talking us and one of the North County Times beat writers, Scott Baer. We were saying, you know, he attacks the boards. I mean, it's not one of those like, I'm going to lay under here and maybe I'll get it and maybe that'll happen. No, I mean, he runs from the perimeter to the boards, jumps over guys, jumps through guys. He's always on the floor. He told me he's wearing the sleeves because his shoulder hurts because he's always on the floor. Apparently, he took a charge in the UNLV game earlier this month and that hurt him. So, I mean, the guy's an animal. It's just an animal. It's Kawhi Leonard 2.0. And don't be surprised if it's in a year or two. I mean, he's going to the NBA just like Kawhi.
Yeah, and you know, it's amazing that he really did it all tonight. He pulled down rebounds, started the fast break, scored buckets, and one thing that really stood out to me, Edward, was the starting lineup change. It's Steve Fisher's tradition to start the seniors on senior night, and that's what he did. Garrett Green was in the starting lineup, and he provided some solid defense down low, was efficient, and also James Rayan came off the bench and nailed some big threes.
This is exactly kind of what I was talking about. You know, we talked about this last week and in mailbags and stuff like that on message boards. You just have to have some kind of energy spark off the bench. James Rayan comes in, hits 4 three-pointers off the bench. I don't think he's made 4 three-pointers all month, you know? So we were joking that maybe he played his way onto the bench. He played so well tonight because he's just better in that role. I think it just suits him better. I think it takes the stress off of him. I think it relaxes him. I think it gets his feet under him. He's not playing defense for 40 minutes, rather, and he can focus more on his offensive game. And Garrett Green played great as a starter. I mean, he's not a slouch as a starting five, you know? So I think Fisher should stay with it. I don't know if he will. I think tonight was more of a ceremonial thing that we got to get Garrett, you know, the pregame introduction and everything. But it worked tonight. I don't see why you wouldn't go back to it, and at least until it stops working.
Mm-hmm. And you know, it's crazy how much of a difference a week makes. Last week, the Aztecs lost 3 straight, lost to Air Force, one of their worst losses in years, and it looked like New Mexico was going to run away with the Mountain West Conference, but with New Mexico losing and the Aztecs winning, there's now a three-way tie for first place in the Mountain West.
Yeah, it's hard to believe. We'd asked Fisher about it in the press conference, and he had a quote that was like, you can go from brilliant to bad really fast in this conference, and it showed. I mean, SDSU went from top 13 in the country to, oh my goodness, is this NIT bound? And now they're back up at the top. Now New Mexico's losers of 2 in a row, and they looked horrible tonight against TCU. So it's a crazy conference, and this Mountain West tournament is going to be even crazier upcoming, so that's why it's important to get this number one seed. And now you're looking at, maybe with the win tonight, maybe you get that RPI schedule, which looks like it's going to be the tiebreaker to be the number one seed if you do go into a three-way tie. So huge win, a huge day for the Aztecs all around.
That's crazy. And Edward, on a final note, there were some recruits here.
Yeah, Matt Shrigley's here as usual, you know, SDC signee. He brought his teammate at La Costa Canyon, Eric Magnuson. I know he's a Michigan signee, but it's still, you know, it's good for the program to have 4-star offensive lineman in here. But the big one tonight was Jordan Poland. He's a 2014 kid from La Jolla Country Day. SDSU loves him, and in fact, so does every Division I school in the country. So, but he was here. That's good for the Aztecs to get him in this atmosphere, this environment, show him what being an Aztec is all about. So, three big recruits there tonight, and it's good for the program.
There you have it. For Edward Lewis, I'm August Gonzalez. Thanks for hanging out with us on the Extra Point with ASR.